This is The Herd, wherever you may be and however you may be listening, live in Los Angeles, iHeartRadio, Fox Sports Radio, and FS1. Christine Leahy is joining me. Doug Gottlieb will stop by in about 3 minutes. It is great to have you in the day after the Super Bowl. Fun first hour, and we think Mike Pereira is going to come on by. I think he'll be really interesting today. Chris Broussard as well. We've got some NBA stuff. I am known as a defender of LeBron James, and one of the things I have said about this is people say he's got an ego. Well, of course he does. I mean, listen, if go to Twitter. If you're the number one salesman in Des Moines, Iowa, you've got an ego. The best basketball player on the planet for 14 years can't have an ego. Michael Jordan didn't have an ego. Kobe didn't have an ego. And I would argue Kobe was never the best player in the game, although he was certainly artistic and fun and exciting and won titles, but he was never the best in the game. Tim Duncan was for some of his peak years. But be that as it may, it's interesting. So LeBron has struggled in January last 3 years, and I've been kind of like, it doesn't mean anything. He's bored out of his mind. Because I think the Western Conference is more of a grind. I mean, Paul Millsap, Paul George, Jimmy Butler, Melo went east to west. All their numbers have gone down. Victor Oladipo was a marginal player west. He's an all-star in the east. Blake Griffin has only been there about a week, but the 3 games he's played with Andre Drummond, analytically, they're tearing it up. Blake Griffin was maybe the 12th best player in the west. I think he's about the 4th or 5th best player in the east. But it's very funny. Steve Kerr was quoted Saturday night saying, "My guys are fried." That was his quote. "My guys are fried." Now think about that. This Warrior unit has been in the spotlight for 2 years, really 1.5 with Durant. They're 41-12. Steve Kerr is like, "We are fried." Here's Steve Kerr Saturday night.
"Our guys are dying to get to the All-Star break. We're limping to the finish line at the All-Star break. And but we got to fight through to the break, and then we need to get the hell away from each other and go sit on a beach and relax, and then we'll be in great shape."
Now, just think about that. We all like Steve Kerr. We think he's honest, authentic, and a real dude. I used to cover him. He's great. He is saying, "My team, being in the spotlight for a year and a half, they're fried at 41-12. LeBron's been the most talked about guy for 14 years in the East, where Goran Dragic, if he was in your living room, you wouldn't notice him, is an all-star in the East, where John Wall leaves the Wizards and they're better without him. Folks, is it possible we could scale back a little on LeBron and say he's bored and a little fried? The Warriors have been in the spotlight for an hour, and Steve Kerr says, our guys need to get away from each other. LeBron's been the talk of the league for 14 years in the mostly embarrassing Eastern Conference. Can't you give him a little space on he's sort of bored when he looks down and goes, Jason Tatum, John Wall and Bradley Beal, Victor Oladipo, Goran Dragic? One, he's bored, and it is possible that he's a little burned out. I said this last week. I think the percentages are low on this. But I don't think it's 100% off the board that LeBron would retire for 1 year to recalibrate. Jordan did it twice. Just think about this. Michael Jordan, without social media, retired twice. People said gambling, burnout, too much. 15 years. Steve Kerr's like, my guys are fried. Some of this in Cleveland could be He's worn out of us, teammates, the spotlight. He's worn out. I'm going to give him a little pass on that. Doug Gottlieb now joins me. Good to see the Dugger or his show after mine on Fox Sports Radio. Only guy that can wear a suit with orange tennis shoes, and it looks fantastic. You know, I try that with my wife. I tell her all the time, Gottlieb does it. And she said, Gottlieb's younger than you, and he played basketball professionally in Europe, and he's allowed to wear tennis shoes with suits. You're not.
They're 29th in defense. Like, you're changing the whole. Now he's bored? They don't play any defense. You know, he's mad. He's mad.
Why? They're,
because Dwayne Wade's washed up. Because Jay Crowder's a shell of the player he was last year. Isaiah Thomas is not as good as they thought he would be. And coming off the hip, he plays no defense. Kevin Love's great on offense, bad on defense. Now he's hurt again. Tristan Thompson's a Kardashian. Look, dude, if he wants to be away from social media, stop going on social media.
Could I make, but what? Is it possible?
Yes.
Just throw it out there. I'm not saying it's a high percentage.
What?
But that he would take a year off and recalibrate and let the, by the way, have you seen the 2000, you have, the 2019 free agent class, and kind of just pick his spot.
He can pick a spot anyway, can he?
It would be better if I knew where everybody, Clay was going, Paul George was going.
Well, I think one of the things that speaks to LeBron's greatness is wherever he goes, someone will want to follow, right? That's the whole argument against Kobe Bryant. Like, if Kobe was so awesome, how come nobody wanted to come to the Lakers and play with him, right?
Yeah.
Okay? People still want to play with LeBron. Like, yeah. I think LeBron has his flaws. He's not. There's no flawless human beings out there. There's no flawless, even great basketball players. But one thing is for certain, that though there are things about being LeBron which can be tedious and tiresome, the fact is, he is a great player. You are going to contend for a championship. And he does like other people scoring and getting shots. So there are plenty of guys that want to play for him, play with him. And if he goes to L.A., there's a good chance Paul George goes with him. I think what's fascinating is he hasn't been playing with the same verve. And maybe it's January, or maybe he's so upset at the way in which this thing has gone down.
South fast.
South in a hurry. Yeah. In a hurry. That he's kind of not playing to force their hand to trade that first-round pick that they acquired that's from the Brooklyn Nets or whatever,
yeah,
in order to go get me another player to try and fix this thing. I don't think ultimately that works, but I feel like that's a more likely possibility than I'm going to shut it down for a year. You mentioned Jordan did it twice. The second time, it was a real retirement. He only came out of retirement because it was his management skills with the Wizards was so bad, he had to try. He's like, fine, I'll do it. I'll show you I can do it. And he still wasn't terrible late in his 30s.
All right. Let me go to the Belichick thing. You know, it's funny because your late father was a basketball coach, and you Eddie Sutton's a Hall of Fame-level basketball coach, and you've been around coaches your whole life. You have relationships with your Krzyzewskis and all these guys. And I do think it's much easier to be a hard ass and loosen up than be loose and then try to be the tough parent. Kids don't buy it.
Correct.
I love Belichick. But if I'm Belichick, Doug, and I ask, go to your coaches. I've asked so much of my players. Take less. Practice more. No talking. No social media. Fewer endorsements. Could I at least say, Bill, your players had the right to ask you, can you at least in one occasion, we're your soldiers, man. You got to let Malcolm play.
All right. First thing is, Malcolm Butler is not Deion Sanders. Deion may have interviewed Malcolm Butler once, but they are. Let's not act like you took Deion Sanders off the football field for the New England Patriots. Could he have helped? Absolutely. Okay. He wasn't having a good year. He shows up a day late. He's not feeling well. He's injured. And he did something that was such an irritant that he got benched. If he was a Dallas Cowboy, he'd probably be the honorary captain. Right? He's a New England Patriot. He sits. And if you want to ask why the Patriots have been to 8 Super Bowls, here's the reason why. That's it. Okay? Did they lose the game? Yes. Is that at least a portion of the reason they lost the game? Sure. I mean, like, they didn't punt. How about that? Right? Like, their best deep threat wide receiver nearly gets his head taken off. He plays in the first quarter and he gets a concussion. He's out. They don't have Julian Edelman all year. They miss a field goal. They miss an extra point with as reliable a kicker as there has been, less Justin Tucker maybe, in the NFL. Okay, so that's 4 points they leave on the field.
Right.
They don't punt. They got Tom and still the Eagles had to convert 2 fourth downs, 1 on a trick play. Tom Brady has to drop something that he probably catches any other day of the week, right? And they still had the ball down 5, and the Eagles make 1 play defensively, and that's the difference in the game. So I hear you. I understand that Belichick probably hurt the percentage chance of him winning, and it was obvious that the Eagles in the first half were
but
like...
you believe the system trumps the player in this moment.
Yes.
And so if you did play him, what you are showing, and this is... By the way, Saban's like this. If you did play Butler, you're sending a message that, okay, you can do this, this, this. Big game, I'll let you play.
You have like 15 kids, right, with the hybrid marriages?
Yeah,
right?
I got kids coming out of my ears.
So if you've ever... Did you Ferber your kids?
Ferber?
Ferber. The Ferber method.
What's that? You know,
when they're crying and you're like not supposed to go in there, right? Don't go in there. Don't go in there.
Like when they're babies.
When they're babies.
Okay.
Because they have to learn to self-soothe. That's the Ferber method. They have to learn it.
Ferber?
Ferber method your kids. Right? You're supposed to go in there and put a hand on them, you know, and just you're okay, and then go back out and they cry and cry. Eventually, they cry themselves to sleep.
I did the Gerber method. Eat more food and go to bed so you stop crying.
Look, the expression in child rearing is don't do once what you aren't willing to do 1,000 times.
Oh, that's interesting.
And if you're willing to bow to him, remember, he sat Wes Welker, and all Wes Welker did was play up the foot fetish that Rex Ryan has.
That's like, true.
Right? So now he didn't sit him for the whole game, but he sat him for a quarter. And all he did was playfully kind of talk trash about an opposing coach.
And it was funny.
It was very
really funny.
By the way, very,
what was that,
well
what was
done.
That coaching? What was that other line, that whole day shouldn't do? What was that again?
Don't do once what you aren't willing to do 1,000 times.
Don't do once what you aren't willing to do 1,000 times. And that's a credo for parents?
That's parenting.
That makes sense.
It's like you have, like, how do you not know this? You have all these kids, and they're all doing really well.
We had a different credo. Where's the vodka?
No, so
yeah, Greg Tuohy, who's got kids, is going, yeah, Colin's right on that. Where's the vodka?
I understand it. He's a hard ass. He's old school. But there's a lot of coaches out there going, like, are you kidding? You shouldn't have to have a curfew for a Super Bowl, right? But to those of us who went to the Twin Cities, and I know you weren't there,
Yeah. Okay,
it wasn't exactly the hoppingest nightlife in the world.
No.
You had to go and try and find trouble.
Okay.
They were staying in a JW Marriott, which connected to the mall. Okay? That's where they were staying. So if you're not in by curfew, if that's what it is, one of it's a curfew violation, that's an IQ test. That's all it is. You're saying you're too dumb to realize you're in a contract year. It's the biggest game of the year. It's your biggest game as a Patriot. This is the moment, by the way, that made you. And you showed up a day late. Okay? You haven't been playing well. You've been injured. What are you doing missing curfew? We're putting the blame on Belichick. The blame is on Malcolm Butler. Whatever he did caused him to get benched. He earned it. And Belichick treated him just like he treats any other player. And that's why they've been to 8 Super Bowls. No other reason. Because they are a do-your-job team. And do-your-job is not just when you're on the football field. Do-your-job is in your preparation. And if you're not prepared to play, I'm not going to stick you out there. Because by his estimation, it doesn't put the team in the best position to win.
You also, let's shift to the catch rule. Because you actually made a prediction on this show. And it came true. And I like to give credit where credit's due. That's the saying for me on the show. Not that whole thing about...
It has nothing to do with parenting.
Don't do once what you wouldn't do. Okay, so... Yeah. So let's retrace.
Yeah, let's retrace what you said, because you got your prediction on the catch rule happened.
So we've had to decide playoff games. We've had to decide home field advantage in the AFC, in the NFC. We've had to decide the Calvin Johnson, of course, play. There's been multiple plays even this year. Austin Seferian Jenkins has lost 2 touchdowns to this ridiculous interpretation of the rule. So the only way it gets changed is if it ruins a Super Bowl, which it inevitably will.
Well, there you go. So I want to ask you, let's go to the Corey Clement play, Sammy. Sammy's an Eagle guy. So here was my takeaway, Doug, that based on what the league has shown me this year, this was incomplete. But what I think it should be is complete, because I believe, Doug, if I gave you a football and I said run for 30 yards, it would shift in your arm if I had milliseconds of video proof, right?
Of course it would. It's an oblong object. It's not meant to be resting, right?
Right.
No, look, this is a catch except by the interpretation of the rule, because it moved before he got 2 additional feet down, right?
Right.
So by letter of the law, it's not a catch. By spirit of the law, of course, it's a catch. And then if you look at the final touchdown, you know, the final touchdown of, I mean, it couldn't be any more perfect that the last touchdown of 2018 or 2017-2018 season was the same play we've seen time and again. Guy catches, he gets 2 feet down, he dives for the end zone, he breaks the plane just like a runner. It should be a touchdown. Well, he hits the ground, and the ground causes the ball to move.
It's not a touchdown. It looks like the Jesse James.
It's the exact same thing.
It's the same play.
All right, maybe he got a couple more steps down. Maybe it's a little bit closer. Okay, but, I mean, it's really hard to determine. And everyone I know, everyone on earth, think this is a touchdown, with the exception of the...
He just takes 2 more steps in the Super Bowl. It's the same kind of... Look at it. By the way, it's a tight end.
And he breaks the plane.
Yes.
Of course, all started with the Calvin Johnson thing, right? But the idea that this is the last touchdown of 2017, 2018, it shows the ridiculousness of an interpretation of the rule. And all this is... And I do think Adele did a great job of pointing out on your show and other shows, which was... that, look, the effort was to make it more simple.
Yeah.
Okay, but there's a law of unintended consequences at work.
Yeah.
And the unintended consequences were it made it a lot more difficult to complete the process, to complete the process of a catch.
Yeah. You know, it is. You mentioned this, and it's funny. Let's say you're in your 20s, and you really just got into the NFL over the last several years, which is some of my audience. It really does go back. The genesis of all this is that game. I believe it was the first game of the year. It was Chicago-Detroit. Here it is. Nice job, guys.
Yeah, Calvin Johnson.
This was the first play. Now watch this in full speed. This was ruled not a catch. Now watch this. This is remarkable.
Well, Calvin Johnson gets it, gets 2 feet down.
They didn't give him a catch. That's not a touchdown.
I know.
I remember watching this and going, I don't understand. My whole life, that was a touchdown. High school, college, pro. This is where it all started. And I look at that now and I'm like, how in the God's name can Calvin Johnson not get a touchdown?
You know what this comes down to, guys? This is very simple. The NFL didn't adjust the rule at that point in time, right? And because they allowed this to fester, they didn't do once what they weren't willing to do 1,000 times.
That comes,
I think
circle.
That's a mic drop. I think I have to leave.
All right, leave. Doug Gottlieb, Fox Sports Radio, right after our show. Good seeing you, bud. Coming up next, some thoughts on Magic Johnson doing as a GM president guy, which he never did as a player. I'll get to that. We're looking forward to a spring being around the corner, but winter is in full swing, and that means your HVAC system is working overtime. If you're not properly maintaining your filters, you're breathing unhealthy air, and that means mold, dust, allergy, aggravating pollution, and dangerous pollen. There is a better way. It's called FilterBuy.com. 600 different filter sizes, custom options, all ship free, within a day, all manufactured right here in America. Right now you can save 5% by simply setting up auto delivery, so you never need to think about air filters again. Not only do you save a little money, you save time and you breathe better. It's filterby.com. That's filter, B-U-Y.com. 600 different filter sizes, all shipped within 24 hours, and all shipped for free. Made in America. Filterby.com, filterby.com.